Hello. Are you a practical person or a theory and research-based individual? By practical, I mean, do you like doing things, typically working on projects, completing the projects, and having a feeling of accomplishment when you see the outcome of your effort or the products that you have developed is being used by others or is available in the market? Or are you more research-oriented and theory-driven? You should choose a university or course according to your strength and interests. But for that, you need to know what are the different university education systems are. Probably you might have come across University of Applied Sciences, especially if you are searching for uni courses in European countries. You might be wondering how they are different from typical universities. International students often find it hard to grasp what distinguishes between a normal universities and University of Applied Sciences. In this video, I am going to explain the differences between University of Applied Sciences and normal universities. Something that you need to know if you are planning for a higher education, especially in Europe. You are listening to Dr. Amir Pichan from CareerUP Global. Welcome to another tutorial video where we explore global education systems, opportunities, challenges, and way forward. University of Applied Sciences are institutions of higher education, widely spread in German-speaking countries, and it is very much popular in Germany. And not only in Germany, but it is also popular in other countries like Austria and Switzerland, where it is termed as Fachhochschule in German language. It is also quite common in Netherlands. France also has got a similar systems. Also, it is very common in Scandinavian countries like Finland. But University of Applied Sciences are not that common in English-speaking countries. But again, what is the main difference? Let us go through it. First, in the normal university, a bachelor's program is often 3 to 4 years. Master's program is between 1 to 2 years. And doctoral program, about 3 to 4 years. This is a structure in a typical universities or any kind of a technical universities too. Whereas in University of Applied Sciences, the typical bachelor program is the same, 3 to 4 years. Master's program is again between 1 to 2 years. And usually, University of Applied Sciences does not offer a doctoral program. That is the general case. This is the main differences when you talk about the course duration. Now, let us look into the main differences between the two types of universities, especially in a European context. Typical universities give more importance and weightage to research. They are research focused, scientific, and mostly theory driven. The primary intention is to create value through research, such as high impact research publications, citations, intellectual property creations, etc. As a result, typical universities can tend to focus less on practical training and application or practical-based skill development for the students, which in turn can result that students will come out of the universities with less job-related skills. Whereas, University of Applied Sciences, or in short, we call it as UAS, as the name suggests, are highly application-oriented, scientific, and very much practical, with much more lab-based training. They provide rich and high-quality teaching and learning. The objective is to produce a workforce with more employability skills and practical knowledge so that they become quickly productive when employed. Internships, industry-based trainings, or projects jointly with the industry are very much part of UAS curriculum. In short, these are the main differences, but both systems has its own merit. It is not advisable to say that one is better than the other one, because the objectives are different and the two university pathways are designed to meet their respective objectives. One is more research focused, aiming to produce a workforce who can think into the future. The other one is more practical based, who can or aiming to produce a workforce who can do and execute projects. Again, traditional universities tend to have larger or crowded classrooms. Therefore, the student to staff ratio is high. This is more so common in the first years of bachelor programs, where more common subjects are taught. There will be less supervisions and expect the students to self-study and put in a lot of efforts by themselves. Whereas, University of Applied Sciences, the classroom sizes are much smaller and there is a much better student to staff ratio and relationships. Also, the UAS professors and the academic staffs have got more both mixed industry and academic background. They are drawn, the workforce is drawn from industry with an academic background. Therefore, the UAS academic staffs bring their not only their industry experience to the teaching, but also their industry contacts, thus helping the students for better placements as they progress through their course. However, in terms of subject wise, typical universities offer all sort of subjects, including medicine, law, pharmacy, biology, social sciences, all science subjects. In addition, they also offer subjects like as politics, philosophy, international relations, you name whatever. Whereas University of Applied Sciences, the subjects are mainly engineering, computing, and business management. Some University of Applied Sciences also offer practical aspects of sciences or social science subjects like applied economics, biotechnology, or applied physics, etc. But in short, in the UAS systems, the subject or choice of subjects are limited and they are mainly engineering or technically focused subjects only. To summarize, one can say that typical universities focus on the why aspects of an academic problem, aiming for cutting-edge research, whereas the University of Applied Sciences focuses on the how aspects of an academic problem, trying to teach, say for example, how an engineering systems are designed, developed, built, and integrated, or deployed, or commissioned. To summarize again, one can say that university systems are better research focused, aiming for innovations and inventions, aiming for the future, whereas US systems are designed to put those available technologies into practical use. Now you might ask, are universities of applied sciences are really good? International students often wonder if US is a good choice for them and doubt whether this type of universities can really cope up with the research-based universities. US, especially in German system, have an equal standing with the research-based universities. US is also a good choice for international students. Both master's and bachelor's program in both type of institutions are considered exactly equal. That means, for job purpose, both degrees are considered equal and they can apply for regardless of which university they graduated from. However, there are some restrictions for example, PhD enrollment in a research-based universities with a master's from UAS. But US students are found to be more happier in their programs and learning experience. Aspects such as mandatory internships, joint projects with industry, and being taught by professors with both industry and academic background make the US programs unique. As a result, employers appreciate US for their strength, and the graduates from US have excellent employability chances with the job market, and they are highly sought after. Statistically, a University of Applied Science graduates find a job faster than their colleagues from universities, and also they get paid more initially. But after a few years in the job, uni graduates tend to earn more, though the gap is not too much to mention anyway. Now, if US is so great, why they do not appear in international university rankings? A very valid question, a very important question too. Well, the answer is simple. Many university ranking systems uses a set of parameters and exclude others when they calculate the university rankings. Often, much more weightage is given to research outputs and research citations, etc. These are the main criteria commonly used for the university rankings. Ranking also goes high depending upon the intellectual property value that the university creates. The level of university also increases depending upon if the university can produce Nobel Prize winners through research, etc. However, University of Applied Sciences are not primarily research focused. Therefore, they do not appear in the ranking list. But no ranking is a perfect measure of the learning outcome. So let the ranking doesn't carry you away in your decision making process. UAS are highly regarded in Germany, internationally, and in all countries where such system exists. US is also well known for their quality of education and training, producing students with much more employability skills. Then, the other important questions that you might ask, as an international student, do UAS offer programs in English? There are about 750 bachelor's and master's programs are offered in English by various University of Applied Sciences in Germany alone. There is also a subtype of University of Applied Sciences known as Technical University of Applied Sciences. They are somewhat similar to technical universities, but with much more practical-oriented training. About 17 such universities are offering nearly 100 programs in English. I'll be addressing all the English language programs offered by such institutions in a later video. So the choice is yours. If you are more hands-on and to develop a career in the industry or corporate world, then US might be a better choice for you. It is also a good choice for international students. While research-based universities are suitable for those who want to build a career along that path, for example, in the academic path, research-oriented path, or in the research field in an industry. Also, the US bachelor's programs are more intense and will enrich the students with excellent working skills. So plan early and try to join for a bachelor program if possible. Hopefully, the information provided is helpful to you in choosing the right type of institutions depending upon what you want to study and what you want to achieve. So see you again in the next video, where I plan to detail different aspects of higher education with much more details and focused. So stay connected and subscribe. So see you soon. Thank you.